All right, first things first, let's try and replace this rear door lock. I measured the opening in there, and it's 5/16, I believe. So I purchased this RV and garage door T-handle with a key. It should be the right shaft size. My only concern is this hole is pretty big, and these holes might be further out than that. Also, again, excuse the wind noise. So that fits right in. Yeah. And the question too is, so this is unlocked, so I can turn it that way to open it. And then, does it lock in this position? Yes. So I think I would install it like this, so I can turn and then lift. Or what I want to do, I think that is the right way to go. All right, what to do, there's a little bit of meat under there, but I don't think that's enough. Okay, change of plan. I do believe I will get a piece of maybe a quarter inch steel that I can cut out a nice shape to this, and then I can tap and thread it and screw a couple of screws through here into the steel, and then maybe on the back side I can tack weld it real quick, the screws to the steel, so that will stay put. And then I'll make this big enough to cover the hole in the door, and then have two mounting points where this can mount more securely. But that's not as important to me as getting this hitch installed, because if I put the hitch in, number one, I can hopefully put it far enough out down here where it'll stick out enough that I can use it as a bit of a step. So when I try and load bikes, I can step up on that. And number two, it'll give me the option, obviously, of pulling a trailer with this, or if I just want to put one bike in the back, and then I can put my bike carrier I've used across here and carry a second bike like that. It just gives me options. So I'm more interested in mounting that right now than I am in putting this on. But I will need that on too, obviously, just for the sake of security. Just want to show you one thing I am doing is I'm going to lube everything with some silicone spray. I'm doing the rails right now, and then I'm going to do inside of here where those legs spin, the hinges, right? I think all of this stuff can use some love like that. Should I get the grime and grit out? Yeah. Am I gonna? No. All right, but you see what I'm doing? I'm just kind of spraying in there. And I think silicone spray is a good choice for what I'm doing. It's what you would use on a garage door regardless. I am also trying to minimize overspray and dripping. I don't want to soak anything that shouldn't be soaked with spray. I will also do, back in there is the spring for the door. I'll loop that. I'm going to do the same thing with all of the door locks. You can see how they're rusty and they just need love, all of this stuff. Oh, thankfully on my trusty old favorite eBay, I found a shop that sells a lot of all these replacement handles, I think in the sizes I need. So I can go ahead and replace these and get them all keyed alike. I don't know if they'll be able to key them to the what I have for the back. They did not have a T-handle for the back. But that's okay. So I can have the same key if I end up drilling that open to put a outside handle. I can have a key for that, this, and this all the same. I'll have a separate ignition key and then a separate back door key. Anyway, I'm gonna keep doing that. I'll also be lubing this. Oh, here's one thing. So this is supposed to be down with a bolt through it, right? And then that engages into that hole. I'm concerned whether I should do that or not. This has a step on it. I don't see how that could possibly lock in. You know, but it's been like this forever. So I'm not sure. And then also I bought a just a handle that I can mount somewhere. So if I'm inside the truck, I can lift it. The other thing I want to find is the shaft from the T-handle extends out. I want to get a non-locking handle I can attach to this side. So if I'm on the inside of this thing and I need to open it and it's unlocked, I can turn it from in here. I didn't find that readily, but it's got to be out there. It's just kind of like a door handle. Because the other thing I plan on doing in here is once the bikes are out, I can put an air mattress on the floor and sleep in here overnight at the track. So instead of having to come home after track day on Saturday night, I can stay put, sleep here, and then be at the track already for the next day. Anyways, alright, I'm just going to keep going ahead and spraying stuff. You don't need to watch all that. So I've gone ahead and lubricated with the silicone all of the rails, both sides, all two, and all of these hinges and the rollers, and anywhere that there was a nut or a bolt, I've tightened in the center as well. I'm trying to wipe up any excess spray. I lubricated the locking mechanism. I still haven't attached this dobobber, not ready to do that. Now I'm going through and I'm still in the back of the truck. Any screws that are loose, anything that needs tightening across the rail, what have you. So I'm going to do all that first in the back here, then I'm going to move to the front and lubricate stuff there. I'll show you what I'm doing once I get there. Okay, you don't really need to see me screwing. Did I mention this cool little vent? Yay! I think eventually I may like to put in an AC unit like RVs have. I don't know much about that, but my neighbor actually sells RVs, so I can speak to them. And there's this light as well, dome light, so I want to see if I have power to it and how to control it. Yay! Well, I was continuing lubricating everything. I got to the front of the truck and Mother Nature decided to nature. So I'm gonna wait it out because I have no windows. Some of the rain's getting in, my plastic kind of fell down a little. I don't know if you could see that. I don't think I'll have time to put the a hitch on today, but we'll see. But once the rain stops, I'm gonna finish up lubricating everything. I will say it's making a huge difference. The door is working wonderfully well. The sliding doors are working great, the locks. So yeah, I'm just gonna take a little breather. I'll wait for the rain to stop and continue on. Good time to see too if there are any drips in the truck. So far so good. It's still drizzling, but the craziest storm is over. And it's still thundering a little. This thing is watertight. That's nice. I shut this. Actually, this I couldn't move this earlier, but I lubed it, so that's a vent. No water in from there. That's good. There is some water in that wheel well, or in that step well, sorry. But that's because I had this cracked open slightly and the plastic has come off. And I'm sure that's not the first time water has gotten in here. But all in all, it looks good. I'm happy about that. Especially this stuff too. I'm assuming this is stock, but there's no water damage really, so that's good. Alright, so everything back here is tightened, lubed. It's working much better, much more smoothly. I did this door and locking mechanism, so before, now it's all wibbly wobbly. I need to tighten. I'm gonna swap out a lot of these bolts for new ones. And I actually have to take this apart because I want to see what size the spindle is in here, because if I am gonna put an external one on that door, I need to know the spindle size. But also, like, this is a lock, I believe, and it wasn't moving or working before, but now it does, so that's good. Everything up here has been lubricated, so that's good. Hopefully the rain didn't wash it away. Okay, so I'm gonna continue. Let me change my battery and I'll fill you in on what we're doing next. A couple of finer points. I lubed, ooh, that's a weird color. I lubed the hinge and then this little spring-loaded thing, and this just works so much easier now. This one here, the push button's working better right there. But this hinge is kind of stuck, and because these three rivets are missing, the whole thing is flexing, so I don't want to force it. I will come in when I'm ready. Tonight I think I'll spray some PB Blaster in there. Rather, it's a penetrating oil. And then I may end up drilling those out and replacing them with, I don't have rivets like this, maybe for the time being some nuts and bolts just to hold it tight. So this way there's not pressure on there. I lubricated this. This moves a lot more easier, and I also saw here there are these neat little divots that lets you put that in the spot you want it. Kind of cool, huh? One thing I noticed here when I lubed this, the pin going through the hinges has walked out that way, I believe. Let's I want to stick this in here and see how. Yeah, it's way back here. I was worried because there's a little bit of a bend to that. I didn't want to knock that in and then see that this won't shut. But I do think it can go up to at least about there. I saw one somewhere else too. Don't remember where. Ah, up here. See how that's sticking out right there? Chai tea. So that's way deep in there too. So I'm gonna tap that into place. Then I want to work on lubing this up. I did a little bit. It's moving a little freer. But I want to free up the sliding mechanism. First things first, let's try working on that. So I took the whole main floor pan out, or the center floor pan. You can see there the transmission. I forgot what this is called, but I was told that I have it written down. But you can take that off and attach a hydraulic pump to it. That works off of the, I guess, gear oil in there. And that's what you would use for a lift gate or something along those lines. So that's kind of cool. I do want to hit all this with degreaser someday and pressure wash it, but not today. This band is the e-brake, but it's out of pad, so it doesn't really work. I need to get a new one, but they're readily available. Okay, let's see what I can accomplish here. Where are you? Right there. Just. There we go. It's in. Hopefully it will still function. While I'm here, these are like Zeus fasteners, D-Z-E-U-S. They use on motorcycle bodywork, and they clip into these wires down here, but I found a little spritz of oil or lube on the wires, and then on these it goes a long way. So I'm gonna do that, and I'll just reinsert that. All right. See that? I'm gonna go to the other side, fold it down, line that stuff up. Nice. I lubed everything up. Oh, this is missing a rivet. Rivet. Future. Huh, that one doesn't want to sit. Let's see why. Hmm.
everything seems copacetic. Not sure. That lube really helped. These wouldn't tighten before. And this is the one that was missing. Man, now the sun's out and it's humid. All right. Just that one is left. Can you see? It's lifted right up there. I'm gonna leave that alone for the moment. Or maybe not. I'm gonna hit it with a big hammer. BFH. It wants to go, but it's just a little proud. Interesting, very interesting. Yeah, that neoprene washer did a good job. Maybe if I put this down first, I want to feel it. Okay, there it is. Yeah, it's way up there. Little loopy loop. Because this rivet is out, it's letting that lift. I don't want to bash on it too much. So close. All right, that's all right. Nope. It's okay. The rest are in a good place. That's fine. Moving on. So this is supposed to tilt. There was a bunch of junk in there. I found nuts, bolts, a crystal. Can you see all this stuff? So, once I spray this up a little, it may move better, hopefully. A little bit. Check it out. Nice. Cool. So now if you look here, can you see that screw right there? I can't see what you're seeing because it's too bright. That's an extra screw to get it to this height. The height's good. The other thing is if you look here, see, so it's got these adjustments to go forward. It's in the most forward position right now. I'm gonna lube that up and play with it a bit. See what can change, if anything.
better.
So there we go, look at that. I lubed these up, I lubed that out. It's, what a difference. And you know, I'm down to here, I'm almost done with this. Isn't that something? That's great. Oh, you know, brain fart. So this was, oh, it was all the way forward. Dang it, I'm thinking it was all the way back. I'll figure it out someday when I'm grown up. I'm trying not to get excess silicone everywhere because that would suck. There we go. Oh, it was all the way back, duh. So I don't need a backing pillow. It's, now it's forward. That might be too much. That's a good thing. All right, I wanna pull this out and see what's going on with that screw. Because it seems very tentatively sitting there. Oh, look at that. So, it looks like from years of, from years of a screw just sort of being like this, rather than having something all the way through, it's chewed that up, and it's chewed that whole way up. Look at the rest. Now, there's nothing to say I can't screw another hole in there rather than this. But I'm gonna see if I can find something longer to stick in there. Hang on. So I'm just going around right now and making sure all the screws holding the back rest are tight. Quite a few, or they're all been loose so far. I'm not overdoing it. Loose and get looser. That tends to make holes bigger and you have problems down the line. The seat's in surprisingly good shape. I think there's one little tear in it. Okay, and lo and behold, this looks like a masonry Hilti drill bit. It was just in a pile of crap I had gotten somewhere, and it's dead. Fits perfectly, and it's long and it's strong. So that's going to be my seat holder upper thing. So it was like that, I believe. I like it too because it sticks out a lot on the side, but I have good purchase. Can you see that right there? All right. And then I'm gonna loop that up a little bit more. So the next thing is this seat. I don't know if it's the stock one. There's no way to attach this to this. Like, I thought there would be screws or something. So what I'm gonna do is take some trusty old zip ties. Place, and then I can zip tie it in a couple of spots to the bottom of this. All right, I'm gonna just do it and then I'll bring you back. So I got some zip ties, but before I do that, I noticed this right around here, this is broken. Now, I'm not gonna spot weld it or anything. I guess it's broken over here too. But I was hoping that I could do something like put a piece of rubber hose over it to keep it from doing that. But this thing's in pretty bad shape. The more I look at it, it's detached from the springs. Let's see what I can do. So I'm just cutting a piece of gas line, 1/4 inch. Now I'm gonna try and slide it over one side, past where it needs to go. Oh shoot. And then on the other side, just like that. And I believe that's supposed to hook in there. And then that's supposed to hook in there. There's the hook. Why don't I mess with this? So there are these little like staple hook thingies that are supposed to hold the springs to these metal rails. I'm gonna go on the other side of the truck where it's shaded. So much better. So if you see here, it's like this is a U-channel and it's supposed to clip over this spring, but it can't because it's squashed. And then this staple looking thing supposed to slide over that to keep it in place. So I'm just gonna play with this a little, trying not to break anything worse than it is, just trying to stabilize it a bit. I've looked at new seats, but they're in the several $100 range. The fact that I can now slide the seat forward makes me happy. So if I can make this work, I want to. I'll bring you back when I'm done. Okay, here's what I did. Where those splits were, I straightened them out, put these rubber hose pieces over them just to kind of give them a way to stay close to each other, and then zip tied the ends of them so they can't easily slip out. I don't know how well it'll work. And then everywhere else that these are U-channel type things went around the spring, I snugged everything down. Now, a lot of these staples like this are for holding the material on, but I'm not gonna mess with that at all. But it feels a whole lot more stable. I'm happy with that. And now I'm gonna go back to the other side and see if there's a way to snug it all down with the zip ties onto the seat frame. It ain't pretty, but it works. So I got zip ties and 2 on this side, 3 in the front, 1 here and 1 here. It's the best I could do. But look, it's staying put, it's not moving. I have it slid all the way forward, so now I can drive like a grandpa, but I can now reach the pedals better. Also, I have a problem with my left leg sometimes, so I need to be as close to that pedal as I can without extending it too much. Okay, I'm stoked about that. Next thing I want to do is take this off and file down the proud parts. Nothing wrong with being proud, but in this case it's not a good thing. Or maybe I should just drill a hole in there. I'm wondering if I should do that, or you know what, I think I'm gonna finish lubing everything and I don't know, I'm sorry. So part of me wants to finish this because perhaps on Monday, but likely next Friday,
I can drive this into town to the glass place so they could take measurements. So if this is done, I know I can use it like that, but you know, it does spin, which is kind of handy rather than just pushing forward. Like I said, I can put another hole in there and have that be the last hole, but then it still doesn't go down. I gotta file it down. But I also want to take apart these and see the spindle sizes and what have you. Let me think for a moment. All right, what I've decided to do is work on the locks because the seat works. You know, it's at the right height I wanted. For now, I can use the pedals fine. So I'm just gonna unbolt this and see what it looks like when I take it off and figure out what's going on with the mystery of no lever on that side. I don't know if there's a way I can, I might be able to set you up over there pointing in here. Let's see. Okay, I apologize ahead of time if my head gets in the way and if the sun comes out. Most of the bolt nuts on here are 7/16, by the way. And I went to Ace Hardware. I have a whole bag of stainless steel hardware to replace this with if I want to. So I can see here, no hole, there is a spacer. Interesting, I wonder if that was like a safety thing, but why wouldn't you want the delivery guy to get in on the side he's driving on? I wonder if it's like a, they don't want you jumping out while it's still moving, because a lot of people do that. Interesting, huh? All right, well that's that. And again, there is no hole drilled in here like I thought. Who knows? Okay, what I'm gonna do now then is put new screws in all the ones I took out and then fight to take out that bottom one. See, can you see? Brand new stainless steel. It's steel that doesn't stain, hence the name. And I got these nuts that have the built-in star washer. I figure it was the easiest way to get this stuff to stay in place. And not rattle itself loose over time. I think too, even though the patina thing is nice, it'll be nice to have nice shiny screws on the door. You wanna see? See what I mean? Shiny new versus rusty old. It looks nice, right? Okay, I'm just gonna go ahead and do that and I'll bring you back. So check it out, new bolts. Have them all facing the same way. It's just a nice thing to do. And there was a fine line between tightening them enough and tightening them too much because this started pulling in. But I also wanted it tight enough so that this doesn't jiggle, you know? And now it shuts. It didn't do that before. It opens, shuts easily, opens easily, right on. Yeah, I don't at all like how that's bowed in, but it was just kept tightening up and tightening up. I'm gonna go do the other side. just want to show you, it's the same thing on this side. A couple differences. One is the outside thing. So these screws go in here. I do need to see what size that spline is. I think that's what that's called. Shaft. To order a new one. And also right here, there should be like a roll pin. I see how there's a pin there. So I'll have to find a like a roll pin or something and pop in there. All right, I'm gonna move forward, shutting off the camera. So I pull this off. You can see that roll pin that's missing. I notice a screw there and a screw there, but then that's missing, or maybe they're snapped off, I don't know. They sell these as well, but they're like 50, 60 bucks a pop. There's a number on there too, 1161. I wonder what that is. And I'll clean that all up. And then there's the shaft. I gotta measure. It looks like 5/16. I gotta measure the length. There was a spacer. Sat right there. And then here's this piece with the spline. Nothing special. Those are the Manzano Mountains. Isn't that gorgeous? Alright. Back to the task at hand. So I've got my ruler. Oh. Hopefully you can see that. That has actually 3/8. Okay, it's good to know, because the other ones were 5/16, the back door. And this one here, I believe. I don't remember now. Oh no, 1, 2, 3, 4. It is 5/16. It's 5/16. See that? 5 of those little baby lines. Okay. And the length is roughly 1 3/4 inches. I remeasured it. It's 3/8. Duh. So here we go. I don't know if you can see that, but it is 3/8 and it's about 2 inches long. All right, I'm just cleaning all this stuff up. I'm not gonna polish that. I'm keeping the patina. New screws, looks good, right? And then here we go, latched. That works. That works. That works. That works. It binds a little going in that way, but who knows, but it's all right. And it comes off that track from time to time, but that's all right. Okay, I'm happy with that. It's getting late. I may futz with this just for a few minutes, same idea. Change whatever screws I need to change, lube it up, and then, but this doesn't move, so I can't actually tighten these screws very well. So I may just have to wait and order a new one of those, which is similar to that. So for the time being, I need that because of the key. I need that because of the key. That I have to decide if I'm gonna drill a hole or not. But it's pretty straightforward, and I think I'd like to. I want to be able to get in from that side. All right, folks. Unless I do something else, I'm gonna call it a night. I've lubed everything in the front here, that hinge. I just need to tighten these and work on that, but that's it. So I'm gonna call it a night. My first time working on the Grumman, I got to know it better. Still more work to do. Like I said, we'll have the hitch. We will have the T-handle on the door. I have to decide how I'm gonna do that. And yeah, all right. Thanks for watching. Again, let me know if you have any questions, any comments, and if you have any information as far as where to get parts or history or anything like that. I would really appreciate it. Take care. Say hi to my bikes. Hi, Branch. And I'll talk to you soon. All right. Bye for now. Hey, real quick, because I spaced it out before. Spaced out, I should say. Getting hungry and tired. This is the driver's side one. I didn't realize that there was a shaft to go through, and there is, and in this spacing plate as well. So I think I will go ahead and order a locking one for this side, that side. And yes, I may drill a hole here, but on the one hand you can say that's not original. On the other hand, you could say it could be, because I believe it might would be an option. Anyway, alrighty, just wanted you to see that. Have a good one.
Bye-bye.
Sorry about the wind noise. One more thing. I think I was right, because look. Look at that hole that's punched in the door already from the factory. So that must have been the guide hole if they wanted to drill through. So I'm drilling through. That's all there is to it. Have a good night.